Good morning. I'm Gerard Vecchio, Managing Director at MarshBerry. With me today is David Paul, Principal at ALIRT Research. Together, we're here to, in preparation for MarshBerry's Impact Conference taking place on November 13th and 14th at the Park Hyatt Hotel in Midtown Manhattan, David and I wanted to give you a preview of the discussions that will comprise the conference. In a word, the new normal, meaning we are in an environment of higher inflation, higher borrowing costs, higher claim costs for the vast majority of the insurance world, and a continued hard market on the P&C side. So with that, David, I'd love your commentary on what do you think is in store for insurance companies in the new normal?
Yeah, it's great to be here. You know, we released a piece just yesterday talking about how some of the smaller U.S. mutual insurers, regional mutuals that are involved in the distribution of personal lines products are really facing a lot of pressure now. We've seen some severe downgrades by AM Best. We think there are going to be more coming. We've also seen not downgrades as well, some downgrades, but certainly outlooks on ratings for some of the large estate farms, the Allstates, the Farmers, et cetera. And what this is all pointing to is that we're really in a situation now where, as you indicated, loss costs are accelerating for all the reasons you said. Obviously, I would add weather-related volatility as well as inflation and certainly reinsurance costs. And so the question is really going to become, where is the capacity to write new business going to come from? I can throw that back to you, or I can kind of give you an answer what I think is going to happen. I always playfully say, where is kind of the dumb money for untenable risks? And for a long time, I think that the reinsurers, not that they're dumb, but they were certainly willing to take risks that they're not willing to take anymore. That started with property. It's leaking into casualty. The primary insurers who are close to the risks, of course, are starting to back away from a lot of these risks as well. We're seeing major groups get out of personal lines business in certain geographies, some getting out of the business altogether, some of the regionals. So then the question really becomes, oh, you know, where's this capacity going to come from? We're seeing the growth of certainly reciprocal exchanges, risk retention groups, which tend to get surplus as part of their design, get surplus from the policyholders themselves. We're also seeing the growth of fronting type companies, alternative, which essentially passes the money through to third party alternative capital, which is obviously a big movement. You know, they obviously would like to tap that capacity as well. The question is that going to be dumb money at some point? We obviously saw a recent blow up with a Vestu situation, which was a collateralized reinsurance platform. So things can go sideways there as well. And lastly, obviously, we have residual markets, and that's where taxpayers or assessments policyholders have to pick up the tab. So it's really a question of, you know, what kind of capacity is going to back risks in this new normal? And I'll stop there and kind of throw it back to you. But it's very interesting, a very dynamic environment right now.
David, you picked up on a lot of the areas where there has been some new capital formation. What I do find interesting is that one of the areas which you didn't mention, which I believe could now reemerge after many years of sitting on the sidelines, might be private equity. The last time private equity came into the insurance carrier markets in Moss was the 2005 Bermuda class of property cat reinsurers. Since then, it has been mostly the capital markets that have taken up that slack in terms of ILS and other sidecar funds. It'll be interesting to see whether or not private equity, in fact, decides that the returns now are such that they can make outsized returns, as you will, in the insurance markets. And with that, what I would leave everyone with is that, you know, one of our panels or several of our panelists at the conference on the 13th and 14th of November will be addressing these and other topics. So if you'd like to hear more, please participate. You can register at MarshBerry's website. And with that, David Paul, Principal at ALIRT Research, thank you for helping me today. Everyone have a great day.